survey monkey poll of the members of MCOA, and we found that 20% of our members are not doing cataract surgeries, and about 10% have not started OP consultations till now. So how can we make our outpatient and our outpatient theater safer, both for us, the healthcare workers who are at great risk, and for our patients who sometimes have to spend a long time within the hospital premises? So we all practice hand washing and wearing a good quality mask. These two are simple steps. But social distancing is becoming more difficult as most of our practices face space constraint, and our numbers are slowly increasing as the patients are demanding more from us. If we strictly reduce the number of patients we see, we'll have to increase the cost per patient to make ourselves economically sustainable, and this is not the ideal situation. We all know that there is leakage above the mask even though it's well fitting, and there's also leakage through the mask, and this releases fine aerosol particles which can carry infectious droplets for several hundred feet within an enclosed building. So wearing a mask alone is not the solution. We will be seeing asymptomatic carriers dropping into a clinic not knowing that they are infectious and causing problems for the other people who are remaining within our hospital. So we have two options to reduce the cumulative risk of exposure to airborne viral particles. One is to use UV lamps. 222 nanometer UVC is approved for continuous use in occupied rooms. This is more expensive and difficult to obtain, while the 254 nanometer is not approved for use in occupied spaces, but it's easily available and less expensive. In this presentation, let us look at the other easy, inexpensive option, which is to increase ventilation. Ventilation can be passive. We can open up all the windows and doors, or it can be active and elective with forced unidirectional airflow designed to carry airborne viral particles outside the building. So here's a simple way in which this can be done. All the material that you see were purchased from Amazon. I use prompt and industrial level exhaust fans, but I reverse them so they are pumping air into the waiting room. These two fans pump air into the waiting room and the air leaves from the front of the building passively through the front door. When you look at the inner side of these two fans, here we see the two fans. They're pumping air inside the room. I have moved my refraction unit, my examination unit, to the main waiting hall. And it is designed so that the fresh air first hits the surgeon, then it bathes the patient, and then it leaves through the front door. Same way in both the examination bays. Because they are quite noisy, I put a black insulation material which has reduced the sound which this giant fan produces. So we have forced inflow of air, fresh air, through the windows and passive outflow through the front door. In this particular movie, we can see an anemometer showing the speed of airflow where I'm seated at the slit lamp. So where my head normally is, we get a speed of about 10 to 15 kilometers per hour. So this is the speed of the breeze which hits me first. And as the breeze first hits me and it is fresh from the outer atmosphere, the virus released from the patient will not infect me. So 70 cubic feet per second is the airflow which is coming into the waiting hall. There is one air exchange every 90 seconds with a potential 45 air exchanges every hour. This is a floor plan of my OPD clinic. So this is the front two fans which you saw in the previous picture. This is a waiting area. There are consultation, optometry and examination rooms on the sides and in the back. So what happens is these six green arrows show where we are having positive forced pumping in of outside air into the hospital. We are having passive outflow shown by the yellow arrow from the main door. And in the back, we are having a giant 24-inch exhaust fan which pumps the air out of the building into the back garden. In some areas, especially where we have the OCT, the Eiffel Masters, the topographies, large volume of outside air will bring a lot of dust inside. And so in those areas, we can use internal air filters with HEPA filters built into it. And this will make it slightly better. The other option that we can consider is to test all our staff for COVID-19 antibodies. This is a blood test which is done by a few major labs. And if they already have antibody levels, you can ask those of our staff who have some level of immunity to do these tests, field tests in an enclosed room, OCT in an enclosed room, so that the exposure to the senior members are less and the exposure to the doctors are less. So we saw how to make the outpatient department slightly more safe than just putting a mask and washing our hands. Now let's look at the operation theater. Now everybody has got their own comfort level. So depending on your comfort level, you can follow one or two or more of these steps. So assume every patient to be an asymptomatic carrier. Please put a nice secure N95 mask for each of the patients. In spite of that, when the patient breathes out, a certain percentage of virons will escape if this patient is an asymptomatic carrier. I thank Dr. Sharmila for providing me the design for this nice head scarf with multiple buttons. So this is we have 7 of these, and you give one for each patient when they come. So all the surgery patients will have a scarf like this so that they can adjust it so that the mask fits each patient securely without being too tight. So this is for the patient. We can also see a small nasal cannula here. This will pump oxygen. This is attached to the Boyle's apparatus. This is pushed into the lower end of the mask close to the jaw and the lower lip. So you can pump in about 3 to 5 liters of oxygen into this mask so the patient is comfortable when after he's draped. For the surgical team, we can use any one or more of the following methods. We can use a ultra HEPA filter. We can exhaust the air that the patient exhales and remove it from the OT. And we can consider using P100 3M masks for the senior staff. So this is a closer view of the headscarf with the multiple buttons. So some of them, it's a small face, you have to put these loops through 2 or 3 of these buttons, while a person like this with a large face will be attached to only a single button. The oxygen cannula is slipped somewhere inside here. If your patient has a beard, please ask him to have a nice shave before he comes for surgery. A thick beard is an indication for cancelling cataract surgery because we can't apply a well-fitting mask to a bearded face. So if you have HEPA filter built into your operation theatre, you can remove your regular HEPA and put ultra HEPA filters, which are supposed to filter 0.1 micron size particle including the coronavirus. So that's one option. The second option is to have an exhaust system. Here you can see a series of aluminium pipes which come down and it starts very close to the patient's neck. The third option is to wear a P100 mask like this made by 3M. So when you sit under the laminar airflow, you can make sure that you are sitting directly under the fresh air, or you position yourself such that you are between the fresh air and one of the razors. You should make sure that your circulating staff do not come between you and the HEPA filter. Elderly staff members and at-risk staff members can be offered a P100 mask. To make it safe for all the people within the OT, you have to tape the exhalation valve on the inner surface of the P100 mask. My OT staff have their COVID-19 antibody levels tested every 2 months. And if they have high antibody levels, they are offered any mask which they prefer. Most of them with high antibody levels prefer the regular surgeon's mask. Those who don't have antibody levels, they prefer the N95 mask. The third step is to create an exhaust system for the exhaled air. So if your operation room has positive pressure ventilation, a 5-inch diameter aluminium pipe will provide an outflow of 2 meters per second, and this will approximately cause a 10 millimeter drop in pressure within your positive pressure of operation theater. If you don't have positive pressure within the operation theater, you can buy inline air pumps. They are available online. So this will permit continuous uninterrupted operation of your theater. You can do several cases one after the other. You don't have to give a break, and you don't have to fear accumulation of coronavirus by one or more patients within the theater. So this is a fall in the pressure. Before the exhaust vent is open, the pressure inside my OT is around 25 to 27 millimeters of mercury. And after the vent is open, it drops down to about 17 kilopascals, 17 millimeters of mercury. So it's an approximate 10 millimeter drop in pressure. And that is a pressure which is driving the air from the OT through those pipes outside the OT. So these are 5-inch pipes. They are normally used in a kitchen exhaust ventilation system. You can buy a set of them, like 5 or 6 of them. Each pipe comes in a 5 feet compressed form, and it can be extended. It can be expanded to about 12 feet or so. So here we see one of my theater nurses. She has very high COVID antibody levels. For the first 3 months, she wore an N95 mask, and now she prefers to wear a surgical mask. Here we have one more theater nurse. She doesn't have COVID antibodies in her blood. She has been tested twice. Both times she's not positive. So she prefers to wear 2 masks. One is a surgical mask and then an N95 on top of that. My colleague is operating and she prefers this P100 mask. This drape, this plastic drape and the green drape below that cover the patient's face, patient's nose, and the entry of this exhaust pipe which is below there. So this forms a kind of a hood, and the air which the exhaled air is sucked out of the OT. The exhaust pipe is placed near the patient's neck, and once you place all the drapes, this entire zone becomes isolated and covered. It forms a kind of a hood from the patient's nose and to the exhaust system. So here we are seeing a small movie of the same anemometer showing the air leaving the operation theater at a speed of approximately 2 meters per second. This is like 6 feet per second. And the air goes out. I had 2 pass boxes inside the OT, and one of them has been converted to take the exhaust the air out, and the other pass box is still being used. So let us all be safe. Thank you for watching. On the right, we have the other end of the pass box. And here we have the exhaust, the aluminum pipe leading out to a window. And it goes outside for about 5 or 6 feet. And the patient breathes is vented out from the theater. There are nice blogs and WHO guidelines about what are the steps you can take to increase ventilation and how it affects COVID-19. If you have time, please read them. So let us adopt measures for our own safety. We should realize we are at higher risk than the patients, and the measures we adopt also help our patients. And we should all plan to be alive and active until we reach 100 years or more. Thank you very much for watching this presentation.